Hey guys, welcome back to another tutorial. In this video, we're gonna tell you 5 tips to improve your motion graphics. Now, these aren't specific to any kind of genre. Hopefully you can apply them to any sort of animation or gaming intro, really whatever you want, to help improve the overall look and professionalism of the design. These aren't in any particular order, so let's go ahead and get started with the first tip. The first thing that I would recommend to do is learn how to use the set matte effect. In both HitFilm Pro and Express, this effect allows you to use the data from one layer and apply it onto another. So if you've ever seen that effect where the video or picture is playing inside of the text layer, this can be accomplished with the set matte effect. You apply it onto the layer that you want to change. So in this case, I'll apply the set matte effect onto this video. For the source layer, I'll select the text that I've created. And then I'll set the matte source to alpha. The blend dropdown and the invert checkbox depend on what kind of result you're wanting to get. Now what I've told this video layer to do is only exist where the text is visible, because I'm using the alpha channel. Once you get the hang of this effect, you can use it for all kinds of things, like having the text slide in out of nowhere, or use it to put one design into another without having to draw all sorts of complicated masks. It's a very simple but powerful effect once you wrap your head around how it works. My next tip is to try adding a bounce to some of your animations, and this applies to whether you've keyframed the position, the rotation, or even the scale of your layer. What you do is you animate your motion as normal, double-click the last keyframe to skip to it, and then move it over 2 or 3 frames. Copy and paste it into your current position. Now on this keyframe, adjust the value so that you overshoot it a little bit. The result is the animation goes past what you originally intended, but quickly bounces back. And this helps make the animation less abrupt and gives it more of a natural motion. Tip number 3 is to learn how to use the different keyframe types as well as the value graph, because they work together. Linear is the default keyframe type, and this means your animation goes from A to B without any sort of smoothing. We have the constant type, which means it'll snap from one position to the other. Then we have the 3 smooth types, smooth, smooth in, and smooth out. This adds a small curve to the animation so that it doesn't stop so suddenly. Then we have the manual Bezier type. This allows you to go into the value graph and adjust the actual curve of the animation. This is the one that gives you the most control. We have a tutorial from Jamie over at Film Empire that shows you exactly how the value graph works, so be sure to give that a watch. Tip number 4, if you have a title in your animation, the font makes a huge difference in the overall look and professionalism of the design. We like to use defont.com because there are a wide variety of different font types, and a lot of them are completely free. Just be sure to hit that little check mark that says 100% free, because similar to pictures and videos, there are copyright laws on fonts. An example of this would be the lower third that you saw at the beginning of this video. When I designed this animation, I specifically chose a font that would work well with the sort of glitchy, futuristic look that I was going for. If I replace it with something like a Windows default font, it doesn't look nearly as good, and it's sort of off balance because we have this really high quality design in the back, but the font is something that we recognize as default. And the final tip is to layer up and add detail into your design. This isn't to say that every motion graphic you make needs to be incredibly complex and have dozens of layers going on. It just means that the more effort and the more detail you put into your graphics and animations, the harder it's going to be for your audience to pick it apart and see the individual layers. Ideally, a lot of the time, your audience shouldn't really be able to pick apart individual elements, and this comes with practice and looking at different reference images and videos to see what extra details you can add into your design. Just take a look at any sort of stock footage or stock animation website to see what kind of details they put into their graphics. They should all be working together so that they appear as one unit. And that's it for this video. Hopefully you found it useful, but do let us know if you have any questions down below. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you all in the next video.